Hi folks, this is an update video on my Raleigh Courier. You'll see other videos on this bike elsewhere, listing all the modifications I've made of it, that sort of thing. Now you might see a little difference, or a large difference, in my potterings about this week. I realised I didn't have a basket on one of my Raleigh Roadsters, or one of my light roadsters. I've got one on my big Tweedy Gazelle, I've got one on my shopping hack Dutch bike, but nothing on an old British 3-speed. So whenever I get an idea into my head about the Roadsters, it's usually the Courier that gets it. So, I love bike baskets. They're so handy, they look good, they just add so much utility to a bike. But I really, really don't like badly mounted bike baskets. I detest them. So the hooks over the handlebars, forget about it. The frames that hook over the handlebars and hang the basket on, even worse. The pieces of flat metal bar that go up from the wheel hub and have two bends in them and go underneath the basket, they're better, but they're still floppy. You need to use something like the lamp bracket as a steady for those things. The best way to mount a basket on a bike is with a rack. Now, if you're not fortunate enough to be able to afford porteur racks and randonneur racks and that sort of thing, like I can't, I used to be able to, you use what you've got. And what I've got is rally parts. I thought, since this is the factory fitted rear carrier on the bike, then I would use the exact same on the front. Fiddled with the bracket until it was mounted perfectly horizontally, but you'll see one difference, it's shorter. I chopped it off, just unceremoniously chopped the tail off it to the first stay, and now it's just the perfect length really. Obviously I couldn't use the bracket that is used on the rear one, that's a double rod onto a flat plate. So I just used a pannier mounting bracket. It's really only there as a steady, as a fore and aft steady. The weight is taken down here. And because it was a long bracket, I was able also to put a bolt onto the mudguard. Those mudguards, they do, when you watch them, they vibrate over the bumps. And I hate anything like that, so I just steadied it as well. Utilitarian, but it works. And this is a test bed bike after all. I used the lamp bracket as a rear steady. This is an Altura pannier cover, this. Covering my shopping, so you can see what I've done there. The lamp bracket, I opened out the ends and used it as a steady. So that is, I can lift the bike up by it now. It's absolutely solid. And it looks nice. Now take this pannier cover off, which is a brilliant practical accessory, of course. You can see I've got shopping in there. There it is. Obviously I painted it the right colour. I think it was black originally, it had been sprayed silver. So I sprayed it the matching red. Okay, I realise that's something not everyone has the facilities for. But I'm giving you the idea of what you can do. And it's transformed the bike, it's absolutely brilliant. The only thing I had to play about with was the headlamp, which of course was mounted under the handlebars. That's now down here on a classic 1980s SG lamp bracket. And that just came from my spare store. There are plenty of other solutions you can use for that. That just happens to be a nice old piece that I had. And it's actually part of an inheritance from a dear old friend called Tom Mason. After his death, I got some of his cycling stuff, and that's one of the bits that was among the boxes of cycling stuff. And it's always nice to have a little bit of dear old Tom on one of my bikes. So there we are. That is, there's a cover. I'm going to show you a saddle cover, but I can't find it now. There it is. I showed you the basket cover. Now how about this little beauty? This actually rides around as part of the bike usually. Raven made it about 7 or 8 years ago. Safe and sound. Keeps prying eyes away from the brooks, and of course it keeps the rain off. And we all heart bikes, don't we?